Again, my opinion is the left just took a major leagues defeat. David Barnson joins us. Now, David normally watches the market for us, but I know he likes politics as well. Are you happy about this big leagues defeat for the left?
First of all, Stuart, I don't like politics. I'm forced to do politics.
Exactly.
it's in my blood, but I've done everything I can to change that, and I'm just stuck as a political junkie. This was a great day for the country, and that's actually not even an entirely political or partisan comment. The difficulties the left had yesterday, as you just got done saying, were self-induced. They were entirely avoidable. This mandate in particular that the Supreme Court struck down was the more obviously inappropriate measure. They knew the makeup of the court. And my theory here is that the greatest benefit is going to be for President Biden, not politically, but in terms of what was about to happen, that the Supreme Court just kept from happening.
Yeah.
The labor shortage problem now is monumental. It's leading to some of these price escalations we're dealing with. And that mandate coming into effect would have exacerbated that problem in a way the administration doesn't want to talk about at parties.
Yep. You know, you're popular on this program with our viewers because every week you bring dividend stocks. High paying, consistently high paying, and growing dividends. You brought two companies with you today, GlaxoSmithKline. What's the yield and why do you like them?
It's a 5% yield, which is a noticeable premium over most in the pharmaceutical space. And it's lately, by the way, gotten a nice little price jump. It had been kind of flatlining for some time. But they have a great R&D program, meaning new drugs that will come on. This year, they're spinning off their consumer products division, which we think unlocks a lot of value. And there's some pretty smart hedge funder guys out there, Paul Singer at Elliott, that are sort of activist engaged, trying to create more value. We could see Glaxo being much higher, and in the meantime, a 5% yield.
You don't normally recommend or like utilities, but I notice you've got American Electric Power on your dividend list. What's it pay?
It pays 3.5%. And the reason I bring up American Electric Power, AEP, good growth of the yield as well, which a lot of utilities don't have. But it's the only utility we own. And you see right now a rotation into some of these defensive names. We think that there's a lot of trouble ahead for the big tech and small tech and NASDAQ and kind of shiny object names. And that rotation into some of these more defensive sectors, you want to own a utility. And AEP is the one with a great 3.5% yield and really nice balance sheet to their company.
David. Microsoft is not a bright, shiny object that we grasp at. No, it's not.
No, Microsoft's not a bright, shiny object. And for years, it was a value stock. For years, it was a dividend growth stock.
Yep.
But it's gotten very expensive, Stuart. So it's just not in the same category. But you're, of course, right. Microsoft and Apple, I don't look at the same way we look at Zoom and Peloton and these names that are down 70% that nobody seems to want to talk about.
I'm not selling Microsoft at this point, shall I put
it? Well, with your capital gain, how could you?
Well, it's in my pension fund, so I wouldn't pay the capital gains tax.
Well done, my friend.
Brilliance, actually. David Barnson, thank you very much, sir. We'll see you again real soon. Have a great weekend, okay? All right.
Thanks, Stuart.